Hi, my name is Jose Luis, and welcome to this mini-series of tutorials where we're having some fun with WebSockets and coordinating data between different clients. And in my previous videos on this playlist, which you can check on the description of this video, what I taught you was how to create P5.js sketches that had some geometry. So for example, this tiny white circle. And I taught you how to coordinate the motion and the animation of this circle between different clients connected to a WebSocket server. So with this, I could click on the screen and then I could make the ball go to this, whatever I was clicking on the mouse, but the coordination of that movement was synchronized between a lot of different clients connected to the server. And no matter which one of them I clicked, I was able to move and coordinate this motion across all of them, which is a really fun thing to do. So in this video, in this new section of the playlist, what I would like to teach you is how to create a Telegram bot that can also connect to this workflow and control the motion of the circles. A Telegram bot is basically a small application that runs on Telegram, which is a very popular messaging, instant messaging application. And what I will teach you how to do is, for example, how to create a basic echo bot where I can tell it, echo hello world, and then the bot will respond with the same message to me. I can program custom commands, as for example, can you greet Jose Luis, and then it's going to send me a custom message, hey Jose Luis, how are you doing? But finally, I will be able to customize more commands, such as for example connecting the functionality of this test bot to the WebSocket services that I have implemented in my previous videos, such that I can, for example, create commands that move these balls that I'm showing you in the clients in real time as well. So I can type, for example, ball, and I can type the relative coordinates on the screen that I want to move the balls to, for example, the center. And if I click enter, you can see how Telegram talks to the WebSocket server and sends coordinates for all of those clients to move. So for example, ball, let's go to 0.2 and 0.3, or let's go to 0.9 and 0.34. or something like that. And then I can control with a chat interface the motion of these objects, which is, in general, it's a really nice thing because this is just an example of motion, graphic motions, but I could control basically anything with this chatbot. I can control the lights in my apartment, I can control geometry in modeling software, I can control a lot of things with this system. So let's get hands-on. And let's start first by discussing what is a Telegram bot, what are the basics of how do we write one, and then by the end, once we have it under control and living on the cloud, we will connect it and integrate it with these WebSocket examples that we have seen previously on this playlist. It's going to be a lot of fun, so follow up with me. I think it's going to be great. Let's take a look at how we're going to do this.